We blew the circuit.
All the power.
Intel just released the brand new 13900KS, which is Intel's newest flagship gaming CPU. And I had to do something special, so I reached out to John and Ellie from Liquid House, and I was like, guys, we need to do something spectacular because this needs to unleash the beast that is this CPU. So at the core of this build, we've got the Core i9-13900KS, which is capable of hitting 6 GHz out of the box. We're gonna be hoping to hit that way more, especially given that we have that Optimus Signature V2 water block, which is absolutely stunning and performant. We're gonna be putting this inside of the ASUS ROG Maximus Z790 Apex board. Now, to take advantage of the 2-DIMM configuration, we went to our friends Kingston, and we grabbed the Kingston Fury Renegade DDR5 for extreme performance at 7200 megatransfers. We're also using 2 2-terabyte Kingston Fury Renegade PCIe Gen 4 NVMe drives at 7,000 megabits per second. Let's talk about radiators, because we got dual Hardware Labs 360 millimeter GTS radiators with Fantex T30 fans. Oh, and by the way, we are only cooling the CPU here. So that means we have 720 millimeters of radiators we need to push water flow through. That's a lot of liquid. So we're using a Liquid House developed bracket capable of holding dual DVC pumps. Oh, and by the way, that bracket will soon be available for purchase. We need all the liquid for cooling, and this is going to ensure we get it. The NZXT H7 Flow case has all the space and airflow we need to ensure those Fantex T30 fans are getting all the air they could potentially need. Lastly, for power, we're gonna use NZXT C1000 Gold PSU. With 1000 watts, we're gonna have more than enough power to ensure what we need to do to get the best out of the CPU. We need to have an equally awesome GPU. So what better than the brand new and stunning white ROG Strix RTX 4080? So let's see what we can do to push our 13900KS to the brink. We're gonna be using Hardware Info Monitor to just ensure that we're getting the temps and seeing what our CPU is actually doing. We're gonna be using Cinebench just to ensure that things are stable. And then lastly, we're gonna be using XTU to do all of our overclocking and tweak all of our different values. So let's see if we can get it as a baseline and then what we're capable of. My temperature's right now in the 30s. Starting things off, okay, we're in the 70s, 80s. Okay, that's actually not bad, because that means we got 16, 17 degrees to play with. We're just gonna jump up to 5.7, run our multi-core, and let's see what the temperatures jump up to now. Okay, 82, 83. We have a little bit more room here, so we're gonna do the same thing. Let's go up to 5.8. Now we're gonna have to give this a little bit more voltage, I'm guessing, and let's see what we'd get here. That's it right there. 5.7 is actually the safe place for where we're gonna sit on this build. I know we can do so much more, and okay, unfortunately, I'm all out of liquid nitrogen. What I do have is 720 millimeters in radiators and really good fans, which means a lot of airflow, and I need air. I need really cold air. Oh, I know what I can do. And this is the point when I underestimated the impact of extreme cold on a high performance PC. Oh, shoot. Oh. So we had this sitting in the ice bar for about an hour. And then what we now have is parts of it have frozen essentially. And then when we tried to heat it up to try and get it to go, we actually saw it shoot out. We have Liquid House on this way. We're gonna see if we can get this to thaw down, and then we'll try and fix the fittings and all that sort of stuff, and then get it ready for another run.
It froze while it was running?
It was the temp on the CPU was at 7. Maybe the pumps were like, I don't know how to deal with this cold. This is all stuff that nobody does this, right? So, all right, here we go.
We're just gonna have to wait. Assuming a lot of air.
There it goes. Luckily, it hasn't fried any components in this very, very high-end PC. So here's the plan. What we know is we can see it's flowing. The pumps are all fine. It looks like everything's good. We're gonna go start talking about it, because we did spend some time with the KS, but you know what? Honestly, videos like this, you gotta pivot sometimes. Okay, first and foremost, for people who don't know who you are, Marcus Kennedy, head of gaming at Intel. So huge shout out, number one, to Intel for letting us do this. It's not going the way that we anticipated as we look at the frozen remnants of some of our cooling right now. But it's awesome to get to do something like this for such a cool product.
This really is the coolest thing that we've ever done. And but yeah, I mean, one of the great things about these kinds of live demonstrations and what you do is that you get to do some of these really interesting things that nobody has ever thought of before. But sometimes that comes with, you know, unexpected circumstances that we got to work through, right?
Speaking of that, like we had to do something. You're talking about like doing cool things like this. We had to do something special for the KS launch.
But yeah.
What is the KS? I mean, a lot of people, like for a lot of people who see this for the first time, they may not understand. So KS, like give it to me in a couple sentences.
Yeah, so really straightforward. First, the K series is K-SKU. What that is the unclockable series. And the way we do that is we cherry pick the best products out of our manufacturing line to make sure they're the best of the best that allow you to overclock.
Okay.
The KS then is the best of the best of the best. It's the top of the line, and it allows us to do the fastest products we've ever made. And so we do the KS specifically for our community because we know how much the overclocking community just wants to be the fastest.
Okay, and that makes sense, right? Because the rig that we built, I mean, 720 millimeters of radiator, right? Like, we built
a lot.
The ultimate to try and make sure that we could contain the beast,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And so that's kind of what the KS is for. It's not just for the average individual, right?
No, yeah, it's not.
And these are usually limited, aren't they?
They are. It's limited quantities for the enthusiasts who really want that power, to really want to push the limits of whatever they can. And by the way, the really great thing about this is it's the first product that we're actually getting 6 gigahertz out of the box.
Cool thing is like I was excited to see what we can do in here.
I can't wait.
If everything goes well.
Yeah.
But we're gonna see what happens. So we're gonna go fill the loop, see if we've got a working system. We're replacing the offending fitting. We don't actually know if the fitting, we thought we got it to stick, but at this point in time.
It's a combination of the water freezing expansion. There wasn't much air in the system. Remember, we really topped it off. So we should have looked into maybe leaving a little bit of room for expansion because water's going to freeze. Another thing too is with this last minute craziness, we should have had a actual premix. Actual fluid that's meant for lower freezing point. So this exact thing doesn't even happen.
And again, the way that we thought this was gonna work, right, is we were like, oh, we'll just have it running. But then when we saw the idle got to 7, it just got to the point where it was too much. Now, we are in a bar, and we did think, hey, what if we added vodka? But the problem is that there's a chance, and this is just for some education, that it could actually spiderweb the acrylic and stuff like that. At this point, we're gonna go, step 2 is, let's see if we can get it to work. We're gonna have it be in there for a limited time, but then run Cinebench immediately so the temp on the CPU is high to keep the entire system warm. So that's where we're at.
Feeling confident though.
Yes.
Yeah, we should be okay.
If it's trying to flow, come on, flow, baby. So we took it into the ice bar, and then we noticed immediately when we started benching it, which was, you know, we actually did it in an ice bar.
In an ice bar.
Unfortunately, it immediately thermal throttled,
yeah.
And that's because we had bad flow. So what we had is when this whole thing happened, we lost a lot of water, and that means we had a lot of air in the pump. And so what we're working on is we're like, okay, we're not gonna be able to get the air out when the water's, you know, starting to freeze up. So we're now back out here, getting it to flow better, retopping it off, and then we're gonna go to take 3. Liquid has basically gotten it flowing again. We've re-tapped it off. It looks like we are in good shape.
Let's
Hopefully
go.
We're gonna overclock a KS. Here's where we're at.
Let's go.
We have good flow. Everything's ready. Temps are sitting at 22 degrees.
Oof.
That seems good. That
yep.
means that we have good flow.
Yep.
What we're gonna do is we're just gonna open up XTU, default settings across
go.
The board. So if we're better than 70, then we're in good shape, and we can then push this. Okay, so here
All
we
right.
go. It's running.
Cinebench is running.
60, we are 10, almost 11.
That is,
it's still dropping. It's dropping.
The ice bar.
The ice bar is
doing it.
Okay, so we are now almost 12 degrees less than we were just sitting at the place, and this is like we haven't done anything yet.
That is,
okay, we can stop that. Now it's time to start playing, my friend.
All core, 5.9.
All core, 5.9. That's where we're at right now. We haven't given any other voltage. Let's just see what the temps are going to do here. And our temps are right now sitting at
80.
80. We're at 5.9 and 80. Holy moly.
In the ice bar.
In the ice bar.
In the ice bar. Now we lost all the power.
We blew the circuit.
Oh my God, we blew the circuit.
All the power! The ice bar took down our build, but we took down the ice bar!
Woo!
Ice bar is giving us the thumbs up. We're okay.
Whew.
Okay. And I think that's it.
All right.
We got 5.9 all core at 80 degrees.
Yep.
So again, we had plenty of room to overclock.
Yep.
What we are learning is that we are taking this PC to the limits, and not in regards to its capability to cool, but limits in terms of its just ability to deal with the temperature that we're in. It is freaking cold. I don't know if you guys see behind us, everybody is wearing, I mean, I'm wearing two jackets. You're wearing a Jaguar hat.
A Jaguar hat, my Intel jacket, and this great fur coat.
Yeah. We could have probably gotten 6'1", 6'2", very easily.
Oh, absolutely. We could have gotten at least another three.
I'm sorry we couldn't have seen it, but you have to give props to, you know, honestly, John Liquid House is over here trying to get the build doing it.
He's been doing a great job with this.
He has made the build was fantastic. Amazing build. I mean, all in all, we had 20 plus degrees to play with, and it'll be an interesting experiment to think of something that we can do to maybe do this as a V2 later on. But I want to give a huge shout out to Intel, honestly, for giving us the opportunity to do something so rad with such a cool piece of hardware, because I couldn't think of a better CPU to do it with, because that's what this is about, right?
This was super cool, and this, you know, we did get to 5.9 all core. Right? In this environment, I think just being able to do that, and you guys being so game to do something this incredibly radical, it was just really cool to do.
Real quick, January 12th.
Yep.
It's available.
It's available.
Limited amount. So get it, if you're gonna get it when it
get
comes
it, get
out.
Get it as soon as it
get
comes
it
out.
Get it as soon as it comes out. And then again, think about it for the people who are this is targeting. This is for your enthusiasts. You gotta think about the cooling. To get the most out of the CPU,
it is.
We need builds like what Liquid House built for us here
today.
Yeah,
that's absolutely right. I mean, the KS SKU set is really for those enthusiasts. Yep. It's for those who wanna get the most out of your systems. And if you wanna overclock, this is a great process. And it'll be great to see what you all do with it when you finally get your hands on this, even if you're not building it in
iSpar. Always a challenge though. Like, what do we do next? I mean, you see us build something in an iSpar. What else can we do? We'd love to see that down in the comments below. And while you're down there, what do? They
like and subscribe like I did.
That's right, there you go. Like and subscribe. And also, join our Discord, discord.gg/Robitech, where you can go and have discussions about these very awesome things. And maybe tell us, maybe we'll learn some things that maybe we could do in the future if we decide to do this again.
I'm sure we'll get suggestions.
A huge shout out to NZXT, to ASUS, and of course, Intel for allowing us to do this again. Guys, we hope you enjoy this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.
Let's go get warm.
Oh yeah, for sure. Ooh, it's freaking cold.